Hi. One of the most difficult tasks as a doctor is to share information with parents where the child or the baby has a possible neurological injury. There may be implications for the future, but at this stage, we don't know for sure the extent of the damage. This depends on the scenario, obviously. So it could be a very premature baby who has a grade 3 or grade 4 intraventricular hemorrhage, or it could be a preterm baby developing post-hemorrhagic hydrocephalus. It could also be a term baby with perinatal asphyxia and MRA showing abnormalities, which would suggest long-term neurological injury. I would recommend you to review my earlier videos on empathy and breaking bad news as well. I'll share the link to that video. The most important aspect is openness and a clear understanding of the extent or the baseline knowledge that the parents have, and work on that, expand on that. We need to acknowledge the uncertainty because no one can be sure of what the outcome will be. At the same time, we have to be realistic. We should be giving them the factual information that we have and the likely expectation based on our experience seeing such cases in the past. Of course, there are always exceptions. So where the chances are that the baby will have problems, but there is a small chance that the baby may not have major problems, it's acceptable to give them the hope, because the parent has to function with hope and they have to have some optimism in order to function well as a parent. They need to stimulate the child. They need to do their best to make the child develop. So if they are totally in a hopeless situation, they will be depressed. They may not be able to support the child. So the balance has to be struck. We need to give them the information that is needed. We need to acknowledge that whatever information we have, the clinical examination findings, the MRA findings, even though they point to a direction, only time will be the factor that gives us with clear certainty. You can give them a time frame as to when you are expecting, for example, a newborn baby. You can say by 6 months, if the child doesn't have problems, you are ruling out very significant abnormalities like severe cerebral palsy. The child reaching 1 year plus, you can say the development is better. We still cannot rule out schooling difficulties and subtle learning difficulties at that stage. And as the child becomes preschool toddler who is developing well, you can be reasonably confident that the child is developing well. We cannot say for sure in any case that a child will be absolutely normal, even in a normal baby who is born perfectly, who is developing normally. We cannot say for sure that the child will be normal for sure in the future. So that guarantee cannot be given. However, as the time progresses, we have to revise our estimate. Whatever we spoke to the family in the beginning, you can even get back to them and say, even though we mentioned this in the earlier stages, now it becomes clearer that your baby is developing reasonably well. So just to sum up, you need to collect all the information you have, the clinical assessment, the neurological scoring. So you may take the opinion of the physiotherapist, occupational therapist in your team. If you have access to a pediatric neurologist, seek their opinion as well. Review the imaging findings carefully to clearly understand what they convey. So the brain is quite plastic. They can develop and overcome chair challenges. So stimulation, focus on the importance of stimulation, early intervention treatment, so that the parents understand the importance of molding and channeling the development in the right direction. And then you have a clear chat with the family and update them on a regular basis subsequently, explaining whatever findings are there, and not to focus too much on only the negatives, to focus on the positives, especially as a child starts performing well. For example, a HAE baby, if the baby is ready to suck feeds and is discharged by day 5 to 7, even though the baby had a significant initial encephalopathy, this rapid improvement will be encouraging. So a baby who is comatose for a few weeks, you don't have much hope of doing normally. Similarly, there are conditions that you may diagnose like neurodegenerative disorders where the prognosis is poor. So in such cases, you have to be open with the family and confirm what the suspicion they have. So it's a challenging topic. It's not easy for anyone concerned. It's always good to observe your seniors doing it, and maybe you can ask them to feedback if you're doing it yourself. So take them along to encourage and observe you. You can later on, once you get the rapport, you can ask the parents how they felt in the initial discussion that you had with them. So an honest feedback from the family would be